by carbocation replacement by nitrite group. So nitrite group is the NO2. So for example, alkyl halide RX, it is treated with nitro group. It is treated with the nitro group. For example, let us consider potassium nitrite, then the obtained compound is alkyl with the nitrite group, that is RNO2 group plus KX is obtained. So the representation of RNO2 is R single bond N, O single bond N double bond O. So wherein nitroalkanes is obtained. So it is explained with one suitable example, ethyl chloride C2H5Cl. It is treated with potassium nitrite. So then the obtained compound is ethyl C2H5. It is O, N, it is a double bond O. So then potassium combines with chlorine. It gives potassium, it is chloride. So it is the nitroethane. So where nitroethane is the major product in this process. So now let us consider, it is explained with the second example. For example, C2H5Cl ethyl chloride. It is treated with AgNO2. So then it gives C2H5NO2 plus AgCl. So now this compound representation is CH3CH2. It is N double bond O. So it is a day two bond of oxygen NO2 plus it is AgCl is obtained. AgCl is obtained. So generally, what is the product obtained by hydrolysis of the moisture silver? For example, Ag2O, it is moisture silver on hydrolysis H2O. So then it gives silver hydroxide AgOH. Now this AgOH is treated with alkyl halide, for example C2H5Cl plus AgOH. Then ethyl group combines with OH group, so then C2H5OH plus AgCl. So it is the ethyl alcohol. So moisture silver oxide on hydrolysis, it gives silver hydroxide. Then silver hydroxide is treated with ethyl chloride. Then carbocation is replaced by OH group. It means hydroxyl group. It gives the alcohols. The obtained compound is ethyl alcohol. Then after completion of the carbocation replacement reactions, we are going to discuss about ambidentate nucleophiles. So it is a simple concept. Ambidentate
nucleophiles ambidentate nucleophiles.
Ambi means dual. It means in a nucleophile both two atoms are donate the pair of electrons. Actually nucleophiles are ready to donate the pair of electrons because these are the nucleus seeking groups. These are electron rich species, so these are act as Lewis bases.
So best examples of the ambidentate ligands is CN cyano and NO2 nitro groups. So for example, if you take CN cyano group, so it is C, it is a triple bond, it is a N, triple bond N, carbon with positive charge. So wherein nitrogen is ready to donate the pair of electron. So same as C, double bond N, it is positive charge, it is a negative charge, carbon with one lone pair of electron. In this nucleophile, carbon ready to donate the pair of electron. In this nucleophile, nitrogen is ready to donate the pair of electron.
So it means in a nucleophile, both atoms are ready to donate the pair of electrons is called ambidentate ligands. So then after completion of the ambidentate ligands, so then next chemical property of the alkyl halides is elimination reactions. Elimination reactions. So these elimination reactions is also known as beta elimination
reactions.
Why it is considered as beta elimination reactions? Actually, this type of reactions are present in alkenes. In an alkene, hydrogen is present at a beta carbon. So this elimination is known as beta elimination reaction. So generally this reaction is also known as Sedjef's rule. This reaction is also known as Sedjef's rule. So in Sedjef's rule, elimination of beta hydrogen from the asymmetric alkenes. So it is explained with one suitable example, that is 2-bromo pentane. So meet, eat, propute, pent, 5 carbons. Second carbon with bromine, it is Br. So CH3, CH2, CH2, CH, it is CH3. Now halogen is attached to this carbon. So this carbon is alpha carbon. This carbon is beta carbon. This carbon also considered as a beta carbon. This carbon also considered as beta carbon. Now elimination of the hydrogen from the beta carbon, then it gives two products. One is major product, another one is a minor product. Major product is stable compound, minor product is the unstable compound. For example, hydrogen. This hydrogen is present at the beta carbon. So now replacement or elimination of hydrogen from this carbon, so the obtained compound is, so actually this reaction is dehydrohalogenation reaction. Dehydrohalogenation means
means removal of hydrogen and halogen, that is minus HBr. So then the obtained compound is CH3 single bond CH2 single bond CH2 double bond CH, it is CH double bond CH, it is CH3. So in this phenomenon, removal elimination of the hydrogen from this beta carbon. So now single bond converted into double bond. The name of the compound is 1,2. It is the second carbon with a double bond. Meet it propbutpent. It is the 1-pentene. So the first carbon, the second carbon. The name of the compound is 2-pentene. It is the major component. Its composition is 81%. So again, removal of hydrogen from this beta carbon. So this hydrogen also beta hydrogen. So then dehydrohalogenation minus HBr. So the obtained compound is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now hydrogen is replaced from this carbon, beta carbon. So single bond converted into double bond, CH3 converted into CH2. So then it is CH, it is CH2, it is CH2 and it is CH3. So now double bond is present at first carbon. The root bond is meet it propbutpent. So the name of the compound is 1-pentene. It is the minor compound. Its composition is 19% only. So elimination reactions is also known as beta elimination reactions, because the elimination of hydrogen from the beta carbon of alkenes. So then hydrogen is present at beta carbon. This rule is also known as Sedgef rule. Sedgef rule, it is explained with 2-bromopentane. So then dehydrohalogenation, two compounds are obtained. One is 2-pentene, it is a major component, it is 81%. 1-pentene is minor compound, it is the 19%. So it is the elimination reactions of the alkyl halides. So now after completion of the elimination reactions of alkyl halides, then we are going to discuss about alkyl halides Rx. So alkyl halides react with the metals. So then alkyl halides reaction with metals. So simply this phenomenon or this reaction is known as Wood-Jew reaction. What is a Wood-Jew reaction? So Wood-Jew reaction means two moles of alkyl halide, for example it is Rx alkyl halide, treated with sodium, not only sodium, any metal reactions, sodium. So then 2 Na, another mole of alkyl halide, it is Rx. So Rx, two moles of alkyl halides are treated with sodium metal in the presence of dry ether. Is known as Wood-Jew reaction. So then X, 2 Na, and it is X. So then the obtained compound is alkyl and it is alkyl. So alkyl with alkyl, it is the hydrocarbon. These hydrocarbons are saturated hydrocarbons plus 2NaX. So this reaction is known as Wood-Jew reaction. Wood-Jew reaction means sodium metal reacting with alkyl halides in the presence of dry ether.
It gives the hydrocarbons, or simply higher alkenes. It is the higher alkenes. It is higher alkenes. So now it is explained with one suitable example. For example, if you take ethyl chloride C2H5Cl plus 2 moles of sodium plus another mole of ethyl chloride, 2 moles of haloalkanes. So now Cl2Na plus Cl, so then it is 2NaCl. So the reaction undergoes in the presence of dry ether. The obtained compound is ethyl and ethyne. So it is C2H5. It is also C2H5 plus 2 moles of NaCl. So ethyl, 2 moles, it is the simply C4H10. C2, C4, 5 plus 4, C4H10. So it is the butane. It is the butane. So in Budge reaction, lower alkyl halides are converted into higher alkanes. So it is the reaction with the metals of alkyl halides. Now second example is reaction with the magnesium. Reaction with the magnesium. So then alkyl halide is treated with the magnesium. Magnesium in the presence of dry ether. In the presence of dry ether, it gives alkyl magnesium halide. So alkyl magnesium halide representation is known as Grignard reagents. These are the Grignard reagents. So for example, so it is explained with one suitable example. Ethyl chloride C2H5Cl, it is treated with magnesium. In the presence of dry ether. So then it gives C2H5MgCl. So alkyl magnesium chlorides. So ethyl magnesium chloride, it is the Grignard reagent. So then Grignard reagents, what are Grignard reagents? RMgX. On hydrolysis of the Grignard reagents, hydrolysis means treated with OH. So then H combines with hydrogen, it gives HCl. So then alkyl magnesium OH group. So then it is R, alkyl, it is OH, it is the Mg plus HCl. So for example, ethyl magnesium chloride, it is treated with water, HOH. So then it gives C2H5OH and magnesium. So then H combines with Cl, it gives HCl. So these are the alkyl halides react with metals. So now next chemical property of the alkyl halide is reduction reactions. So alkyl halides are involved in reduction reactions. So now reduction. So simply reduction means addition of hydrogen, removal of electron, or addition of hydrogen, gain of electron, loss of oxygen. If the oxidation number decreases from one value to another value, is called reduction reactions. So then generally these reactions are undergoes in the presence of nascent hydrogen. So nascent hydrogen. So for example, alkyl halide RX,
It is treated with two nascent hydrogens. Nascent hydrogens. Generally, these reactions are undergoes in the presence of reducing agents. Generally, what are the reducing agents? Zinc HCl. Couple of zinc and HCl act as reducing agent. Same as sodium ethyl alcohol C2H5OH. So third one is lithium aluminium hydride. So then fourth one is addition of hydrogen in the presence of nickel and platinum. So these are all the reducing agents. So now halogen is replaced by hydrogen. So then obtained compound is alkyl and hydrogen. So these are the alkanes. These are the alkanes. So then plus it is HX. It is the HX. So for example, let us consider ethyl chloride C2H5Cl plus two nascent hydrogens. Nascent hydrogens. So in the presence of zinc HCl, couple of zinc and HCl, then it gives C2H5, it is H plus HCl. HCl. So this compound is C2H6. It is the alkane. Its name is ethane. Its name is ethane. So in reduction reactions, alkyl halides are reduced to alkanes. So then finally, final chemical property of the alkyl halides is Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Generally, these type of reactions are undergoes in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3 or FeCl3 or simply iron. So these are the Lewis acids, electron deficient species. So in this reaction, alkyl halide is treated with C6H6. It is a benzene, treated with benzene. So then in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, anhydrous AlCl3, halogen is replaced by benzene. So then it is a C6H5 phenyl group with alkyl group. Halobenzenes are obtained. Alkyl benzene is obtained. So then H combines with X. So it is explained with one suitable example. Ethyl chloride C2H5Cl. It is treated with benzene. Treated with benzene in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. It gives C6H5. So minus H and minus Cl. So then it is HCl. So it is the simply it is a phenyl group with C2H5. It is ethyl benzene. So these are the chemical properties of the alkyl halides. So final reaction is Friedel-Crafts alkylation reactions. This reaction undergoes in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. So then alkyl halides are treated with benzene. It gives alkyl benzene. Example is ethyl chloride treated with benzene. In the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, it gives ethyl benzene.